Welcome to Liberty Today. Laura Hubbell is here today to talk with Tanchi Weaver about Common Core. We'll also hear about an upcoming series of programs detailing the threats and dangers of Common Core. And Sam Kephart is raising the alarm about aliens. No, not the little green kind. On today's Liberty Today.
Hello, I'm Laura Hubbell, and I'm going to introduce a friend of mine and, in my opinion, an expert on Common Core. Because of her research, because of her knowledge, and because of her unique way of being able to dig deep into a situation. So Tanchi Weaver from Rapid City, glad to have you today.
Thanks, Laura. It's nice to be here.
Yes, I'm glad you're here. Today we're going to talk about Common Core, and let's just start out with the basics. For example, what is the history of Common Core? I know it has to do with Race to the Top, with No Child Left Behind, but can you, just take it from the beginning?
Boy, it's a really broad subject, but what happened under George Bush, a lot of us remember the No Child Left Behind. It sounds really good. No one wants to leave a child behind. They took a look at education in the United States and decided that, well, we need this broad sweeping new reform. And mind you, reform is not new. They do new reforms quite frequently. But this one was a little bit different. It, again, was a big federal move to improve education.
No Child Left Behind, you're talking about.
That's right. President Bush, for whatever reason, gave the job of writing the reforms to then-Senator Kennedy, said Senator Ted Kennedy.
Oh.
And he Senator Ted Kennedy.
What was the reason behind that, do you think?
You know, I think it was one of those reaching across the aisle things, let's be inclusive.
Sure.
And, I'm not going to pretend to guess what his motive was. But the result was that all of a sudden now we had all of this testing, and the teachers were being forced to teach to the test, so
sure.
to speak. No one liked it. It didn't seem to work well.
Yes, I remember hearing educators around that time just complaining about this federal program, and they were surprised that Bush would put it in place. But when you say it was kind of orchestrated by a Senator Ted Kennedy, that makes sense now.
That's true, and I'm sure he didn't sit down at the dining room table and write it out himself. He had a lot of help from his own group of liberal education reformers. Because No Child Left Behind was so bad, people were anxious to get out from under it.
Mm-hmm.
So along comes Common Core. Common Core was brought to us through the National Governors Association.
Could you help me out that, how did we get from Common Core, from No Child Left Behind to Common Core? I hear these acronyms, another one was like Race to the Top. Where does that fit into there?
Race to the Top was the incentive to adopt Common Core because states were so unhappy with No Child Left Behind. They were incentivized to adopt new standards. And Race to the Top is a federal competitive grant program.
Okay, so
it involves
that's what
money.
I wanted to know. Race to the Top was a grant program.
Right.
Okay.
Right, and our application is pretty much like the application that all states filled out. It's specific to our state. But there were some guarantees in that Race to the Top. When the governors signed the Race to the Top application, they had to agree basically to four things. They had to agree to accept the Common Core standards once they were written.
Oh, okay.
So they had to agree to accept them before they were even complete.
That's why our state, when you look at when it was the Race to the Top application, was before the Common Core standards.
That's correct. Mm-hmm. And they also agreed to establish the state longitudinal data study,
this is the
system that collects data on school children. Mm-hmm. And they had to agree to join a national testing consortium and administer these tests to all of the children. Mm-hmm. And finally, they had to agree to teacher and principal evaluation system of ratings. And
so that was under Race to the Top.
Right.
So our governors did know about all these constraints.
Oh, yeah.
Egregious constraints, like data collection on your children.
That's right.
They knew about that.
Mm-hmm.
They knew that they were going to be very hard on their judging of teachers, and yet they, and which is the governor that accepted this?
Which governor accepted it? Governor Rounds did.
Both of them?
And Governor Dugard is doubling down, basically, mm-hmm. on Common Core. But who would agree to something that they hadn't seen?
Sure.
You wouldn't agree to buy a house you hadn't seen, mm-hmm. and without guarantees or even proof that the new standards would work. He's, you know, I would just say that these governors are not very good poker players. they probably own bridges in New York as well.
For sure. But so now we got, our governor decided that we were going to, was there a reason for this? I mean, we're obviously getting money for that.
Well, we didn't get money through Race to the Top, but there have been subsequent grant programs. And if you read page 32 of the application, it says, we agree to adopt these standards and establish the state longitudinal data study, even if we don't get Race to the Top money. It's just that the work will go forward more slowly.
And we did not get that. And I'm going to break right there, Tanshi. We're going to pick this up, how South Dakota got embedded in Common Core.